So the top 11 items that the FEMA says that you all need to have in your possession in case of an emergency in your basic survival kit. Now, I'm Survival Preparedness for Beginners, and today we're going to be talking about what the federal government, FEMA, says should be your top 11 items that you need to have in your survival kit. All right, we all get it, okay? FEMA is somewhat of a controversial government agency. Some people love FEMA because they always bring food and supplies and stuff after a disaster. Other people, we've all seen how things have worked over history. History likes to repeat itself, folks. Don't forget that. But we've all seen how some people hate him because they never bring enough food or supplies to a disaster, or they don't get it there quick enough. Okay, first thing first, it's your responsibility to make sure that you have what you need for your particular area that you live in, where you deal with natural disasters or any type of maybe pandemic or anything else that is unseen and you don't know that's coming. That's why you prepare. Some people also say that FEMA is insufficient and, you know, it's a waste of money. Other people, they argue that, you know, it wouldn't be so bad or so insufficient if it was properly funded and managed. But whatever you really think of FEMA, okay, the people there do have a constant and a desirable goal for all of us to be prepared. And that's why they put out different types of things. So today's video is on the top 11 things that FEMA says that we have to have in our survival kit as Americans. Things we should already have, things that, you know, our basic supplies and everything else. So let's get going on covering this particular topic. Now, number one is, by no surprise, is water. Now, they always tell you in, if you go onto the FEMA website, you know, you need to have at least 3 days of water, okay, and food. All right, 3 days is not enough, folks. All right, I've covered this in several of my videos, but 3 days is a basic minimum supply that you want to make sure that you have. That's just to hopefully get you through until maybe you can get out of the problem area you're in. I would suggest having a minimum of a 2 week supply if that's all you can afford to do. Okay, so if you have at least a 2 week supply of water, you should be pretty good. Now, they say you should have a gallon a day per person, which is fine and dandy, but you have to remember, if you have no water whatsoever, you need that water to drink, you need that water to try to maybe wash yourself a little bit with, to cook with, and all this. So that gallon of water could go pretty quick. So you're going to have to be really good at rationing your water. Food is number two, all right? And once again, they say a 3 day supply. I say you want to have at least a 2 week supply of food on hand per person in your home. All right, it's a lot better to be safe than sorry, folks, because in the end, FEMA's not going to be right there like this to help everybody out. If something majorly happened, maybe they can't get to your area. You have to remember this, folks. It's all based on the availability of them being able to drive into your neighborhood or your local town and help and start distributing food and water. Could take some time. Don't know. Could be trees down, power lines, and everything else. Well, they just can't drive through it. They have to wait for it to be cleared. Number three, an emergency radio. A backup-powered, a crank-powered would probably be your best bet because then you don't have to worry about batteries or anything else. You can just keep cranking it, and hopefully you can get your local information. So getting information on what is going on in that particular situation is top key. Number four, flashlights. All right, if you're going to have flashlights, you got to make sure you have extra batteries. If you buy flashlights nowadays, you can buy the ones that run off regular batteries or rechargeable batteries. Some of them you can even charge with solar panels. So there's quite a wide range of products and flashlights that you can get so that you can see if it is dark out and you have no power. Number 5, first aid kits. All right, now this is a give me. All right, if you have at least your basic boo-boo kit, that's better than nothing. But I've done several videos on first aid kits and how to build them and how you can go about doing it and give you a template to follow. You can add whatever you want to it. You can take away whatever is in my pack that you think that you won't need. But the idea is here, you want to make sure that you have a first aid kit. I would make sure that you have a good first aid kit that can cover different types of situations, burns, cuts, whatever it may be. You just never know. Better to be prepared than sorry. Number 6, a whistle. Now you say, why do I want a whistle? What am I going to do? Whistle Dixie going down the road? No, you are not. But if it's an emergency situation and say something happened and you're pinned down or a tree or something has fallen on your home and you can't get out and you can hear people out there, if you have a whistle available and you start blowing that whistle, more than likely somebody is going to hear you. Now, if you're going to buy a whistle, don't buy a cheap little gum store whistle, you know, that comes out of the old gumball machines. Maybe I'm dating myself here, but you get my point. Buy something that's halfway decent. You can pick one up at Walmart, probably between, you know, $4 and $8. Buy yourself a good whistle that's going to be loud, that can be heard. That's the idea of having the whistle. Number 7, a dust mask. Now, being that the times that we live in right now, I think a mask is probably something most Americans already have. And if you don't, well, then maybe you should pick up at least a dust mask to have in your emergency first aid kit, because after a natural disaster or anything else, and if it's been, say, a hurricane, tornado type situation, and everything's been obliterated, insulation that is floating around in the air, you can't see, you do not want to breathe that in. So you need some way to make sure that you're protecting your lungs, because it could turn really bad really quick for you. Number 8, sanitation supplies. Now this can be any type of sanitation supplies, from wipes and hand sanitizers and maybe some gloves, any type of that type of stuff, you know, any way you can clean yourself, deodorant, toothbrush, toothpaste, you know, I mean, just cover the basics. You want to make sure that you're prepared. Number 9 is a wrench or pliers. Now you ask yourself, why do I need a wrench or a pair of pliers? You can use those to turn on and off water in a certain type of an emergency situation. Spigots and those type of things, you can use those, and they could come in handy for turning off a lot of different things or turning on a lot of different things. Number 10, a very important item to make sure that you have in any kit that you do have, and that is called a manual can opener, folks. Okay, don't rely on some battery powered one, electric one, anything else. Buy a manual can opener. Go to the dollar store and pick one up for a buck. The best buck you ever spent, and it's going to save you a lot of heartache when you're hungry and you're looking at a can. And if you can't open it, well then, what do you do now? You know, you don't want to try using your knife and doing this, because more than likely, somebody's going to get cut. A manual can opener is something you want to make sure that you have in every kit in your home. And number 11, what do we think that one is? Your local maps. And not local maps of your bars and restaurants. Those are probably not going to do you any good. Local maps to get you out of harm's way, to get you out, to get you away from what is going on and the disaster that you're going through. So this way here, you can see all the different roads. If you don't know your area that well, or you just don't have a very good recognition of where you've been and how to get there. Yeah, there are people that are like that. You know, they can go someplace 5 times, but they still just don't remember how to get there. And if your cell phone doesn't work where you can pull up Google Maps and try to get there, well, you know, you're SOL. So make sure you have local maps of your area to get you out of that harm's way in case of an emergency. So this has been the top 11 things that FEMA says we as Americans should have on hand in case of emergency in our basic emergency supply kit. Once again, I'm Survival Preparedness for Beginners. Hope you enjoyed this little quick video. And until next time, I will catch all of you on the flip side. We'll be right back.